Hi to everyone. Welcome to குழந்தைகள் உலகம். Today our topic is memory devices. A memory is just like a human brain. It is used to store data and instruction. Computer memory is the storage space in the computer. When data and instructions are stored, there are two types of accessing method to access the memory. They are sequence access and random access. In sequential access, the memory is accessed in an order manner from starting to end. But in the random access, any byte of memory can be accessed directly without navigating through the previous bytes. See the memory hierarchy: smallest capacity, faster access time and higher cost. Hard disk, main memory, then cache memory. RAM, random access memory. The main memory is otherwise called as the random access memory. This is available in computers in the form of integrated circuit, that is ICs. It is the place in a computer where the operating system, application programs and the data is currently used or kept temporarily so that they can be accessed by the computer processor. The smallest unit of information can be stored in the memory is called as a bit. The memory can be accessed by the collection of 8 bits, which is called as a byte. The byte referred by capital B. RAM is a volatile memory, which means that is stored the information is temporarily, not permanent. As soon as the power is turned off, our data will erase. It also both read and write operations. Types of RAM. There are two basic types of RAM: dynamic RAM, that is DRAM, then static RAM, we will call as SRAM. These two types differ in the technology they use to hold data. Dynamic RAM, being the common type, needs to be refreshed frequently. Static RAM needs to referenced less often, which makes it faster. Hence, static RAM is more expensive than dynamic RAM. ROM, read-only memory. Read-only memory refers to special memory in a computer with pre-recorded data at manufacturing time, which cannot be modified. The stored programs that start the computer and perform diagnostics are available in ROMs. ROM stores critical programs such as programs that boost the computers. Once the data has been written on the ROM chip, it cannot be modified or removed and can only be read. So ROM is called as a non-volatile memory. Programmable read-only memory, that means PROM. Programmable read-only memory is also a volatile memory on which data can be written only once. Once a program has been written on the PROM, it remaining there forever. Unlike the main memory, PROM retains their content even when the computer is turned off. The PROM differ from ROM. PROM is manufactured as a blank memory. Wherever a ROM is programmed during the manufacturing process itself. PROM programmer or PROM burner is used to write data to the PROM chip. This process of programming a PROM is called burning
the PROM.
Erasable Programmable Read Only Memory, that is EPROM. It is a special type of memory which serves as a PROM, but the content can be erased using ultraviolet rays. EPROM retains its contents until it is exposed to ultraviolet light. The ultraviolet light clear its content, making it possible to reprogram the memory. An EPROM differs from a PROM. PROM can be written only once and cannot be erased. EPROM are used too widely in personal computers because they enable the manufacturer to change the content of PROM to replace with update versions or erase the content before the computer is delivered. Do you know, most of the EPROM chips have a transparent area at the top surface which is covered by the stickers. If it got removed, the ultraviolet or in a sunlight may erase the content. EEPROM, electronically erasable programmable read only memory. It is a special type of PROM that can be erased by exposing it to be an electrical charge. Like other type of PROM, EEPROM retains its content even when the power is turned off. Comparing with all other types of PROM, EEPROM is slower in performance. Cache memory. The cache memory is very high speed and expensive memory which is used to speed up the memory retrieval process. Due to its higher cost, the CPU comes with a smaller size of cache memory compared with the size of main memory. Without cache memory, every time the CPU requests the data, it has to be fetched from the main memory, which will consume more time. The idea of instructing a cache is that this extremely fast memory would store the data that is frequently accessed, and if possible, the data that is closer to it. This helps to achieve the fast response time, where the response time refers to how quickly the memory can respond to a read or write request. The arrangement of cache memory between the CPU and the main memory. Secondary storage devices. A computer generally has limited amount of main memory, which is expensive and volatile. To store data and programs permanently, secondary storage devices are used. Secondary storage devices serves as a supportive storage to main memory and they are non-volatile in nature. Secondary storage also called as a backup storage. Hard disks. Hard disk is a magnetic disk on which you can store data. The hard disk has a stacked arrangement of disk accessed by a pair of heads for each of the disks. The hard disks come with a single or double-sided disk. Compact disk, a CD or CD-ROM, is made from 1.2 millimeter thick polycarbonate plastic material. A thin layer of aluminium or gold is applied to the surface. CD data is represented as a tiny indentation known as pits, encoded in a spiral track molded into the top of the polycarbonate layer. The areas between bits are known as the LANs. A motor within the CD player rotates the disk. The capacity of ordinary CD-ROM is 700 megabytes. DVD, digital versatile disc or digital video disc, is an optical disc capacity of storing up to 4.7 GB of data. More than 6 times what a CD can hold, DVDs are often used to store movies at a better quality, like CDs, DVDs, or read with a laser. The disc can have one or two sides and one or two layers of data per side. The number of sides and layers determines how much it can hold. A 12 cm diameter disc with a single side, single layer has 4.7 GB capacity, whereas the single-sided double layer has 8.5 GB capacity. The 8 cm DVD has 1.5 GB capacity. The capacity of a DVD-ROM can be virtually determined by nothing the number of data sites of the disk. Double layer disk are usually gold colored, with single layer sites is usually silver colored. Flash memory devices. Flash memory is a electronic non-volatile computer storage medium that can be electrically erased and reprogrammed. They are either EEPROM or EEPROM. Example for flash memory are pen drives, memory cards, etc. Flash memories can be used in personal computers, personal digital assistants, digital audio players, digital cameras, and mobile phones. Flash memory offers fast access time. The time taken to read or write a character in memory is called access time. The capacity of flash memories vary from 1 GB to 2 terabytes. Blu-ray disc. Blu-ray disc is the high-density optical disc similar to DVD. Blu-ray is the type of disc used for PlayStation games and for playing high definition movies. A double layer Blu-ray disc can store up to 50 GB. This is more than 5 times the capacity of a DVD and above 70 times of CD. The format was developed to enable recording, rewriting, and playback of high definition videos, as well as shorting large amount of data. DVD uses a red laser to read and write data, but Blu-ray used to blue violet laser to write. Hence it is called as a Blu-ray. Ports and interfaces. The motherboard of a computer has many input-output sockets that are connected to the boards or interface found on the rear sides of computer. The external devices can connect to the ports or interface. The various types of ports are given below. First one, serial port, to connect the external devices found in old computers. Parallel port, to connect the printers found in old computers. USB ports, to connect external devices like cameras, scanners, mobile phones, external hard disks and printers to the computer. USB 3.0 is the third major version of the universal serial bus to connected computer with other electronic gadgets. USB 3.0 can transfer the data up to 5 GB per second, USB 3.1 and 3.2 are also released. VGA connector to connect a monitor or any display device like LCD projector. Audio plugs to connect sound speaker, microphone and headphones. PS2 ports to connect mouse and keyboard to PC. SCSI board to connect the hard disk drives and network connectors. High definition multimedia interface is an audio video interface which transfer the uncompressed video and audio data from the video controller to a compatible computer monitor, LCD projector, digital television. Before the topic, I gave link in description. Watch the link, like and share the video and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching.